to y'all, and thank y'all for coming. Today's ceremony marks a bittersweet occasion. One of the finest darn builders to ever grace this humble town will be leaving all of us, but he's off to a well-earned retirement. A few words, Mason? It appears our dear Mason is overwhelmed with emotion. Come on, folks, lighten up. A toast, then, to Mason and to new beginnings for the future of Sandrock.
Somehow this doesn't feel like a party. Come on, y'all. The music's great. Let's have some fun. We can worry about the town's prospects later.
Hey, Gramps. Killing the vibe, man. What's with all the doom and gloom? Sandrock is on the up and up. You hear? Soon, everything's gonna be smooth sailing. I truly believe it.
Justice is right. We have a lot to look forward to. Two new builders. Trudy's close to a breakthrough. Everything will be all right for Sam.
Catch your reflection in a relic shard.
My stars. Seeing your father up there picking and strumming like a mad fool. Brings me back.
Ain't fair, Ma. You and Pa get to pursue y'all's leisures and do whatever y'all want. When's it my turn?
Now, Elsie dear, you still got some growing up to do. I reckon once you show a bit of maturity, like your friend Leanne here, mayhaps we could do to ease off the reins a bit.
Oh, Ma? Mianne ain't no more mature than me. That whoopee cushion we put in Pa's strumming chair the other day was her idea.
What? That's because I lost that bet to you.
Howdy. See ya.
Heat the pan, mix in cream with salt, add the eggs, fry for 3 minutes and 30 seconds. I'm doing everything straight out of the book. Why are my omelets so disliked? Bye.
Look at that stage! Yet another fine example of Sandrock Commerce Guild craftsmanship. My management skills have been tip-top lately. How do I do it? How do I do it?
Take her easy. Take her easy.
Hello. I'll catch you later.
Hey there. Be seeing you.
How's it going?
My friend, you work so hard every day. You
take her easy.
Hey there. Have you seen our cat, Captain? He's a tough little guy, but he gets too friendly sometimes. Don't feed him random things. He might get sick. Catch you later.
This is great! Good food and good music! But I wish my mom could have made it back for this.
You're someone who puts everything you've got into your creations. Towards the end, I thought Mason wasn't really trying anymore. I didn't like that. Catch you later.
Take care. Have a good day.
See ya. Hello. Catch you later.
I'm always serving up tasty dishes on my tables at the Blue Moon.
Hey!
My friend!
Take her easy.
Thank you.
and another one's leaving. At this rate, we're gonna be out of people pretty soon. Not sure what gave you the motivation to come all the way out here, but our town's not in a good situation right now. Hello. Don't forget to stop into Construction Junction sometime. After you let me add some upgrades to your workshop, you'll wonder how you lived without them. Catch you later.
Try kicking a tumbleweed? Catch you later.
about the train.
It's in the back. I'll go.
Everybody hands up. Nobody moves. Hey now, hands up. No funny business.
Well?
I got it. Let's go.
Freeze, Logan. We got you now.
Good day.
Consarn it. Not again.
For my life.
So you're telling me you didn't see anything?
I saw a fire in that man's eyes. A burning desire for vengeance that sent chills.
All right, pal. Did you see anything that will hold up in a court of law?
Not to that effect. No, I didn't.
So let me get this straight. None of y'all saw him take anything. Nobody got robbed?
Excuse me, Captain, sir. Ernest, Atara Times. Would you be able to comment on all the wild allegations surrounding this incident? Who is this Logan, and what are his motivations? Do you believe he may be in possession of weapons of mass destruction?
Dang, you don't get out much, do you, partner? First off, I'm the sheriff around these parts. Captain's the cat. Second, I'm the one asking the questions here, not the other way around. Dang reporters. Almost made me lose my train of thought. Train? Ah, yeah, the train robbing. Or lack thereof. Well, we still got him for attempted hijacking, resisted arrest, unlawful use of firearms. I'll add it to the pile. Y'all are free to go. And remember, if any of y'all think of any info you think we can use to catch Logan, run on back to Civil Court double time.
Wait to get out of this place.
Ha ha! Wandering around aimlessly, eh? That is so you. Great news. I've got something you can do
What's going on around here?
Yes, I was hoping to run into one of you builders.
You see,
that pesky Logan has struck again. More specifically, he struck this here train window. And, yeah, you know the drill. Guess who needs to fix it? Jensen called me over all in a huff. Where, my poor widow Twain? Normally, I wouldn't entertain, let alone reward such babery. But Matilda was standing right there. So, yeah, better get it done quick. But all of that is neither here nor there, since you're here, clearly with nothing better to do. So you'll have no trouble accepting this commission, am I right? The train is stopped now at the station. Just get some glass and fix the window. Should be easy as pie. Well, off you go then. Scoot!
day, partner. Ready to get your ride on? Oh, shoot.
You know what makes the Sandrock Commerce Guild great? Hard-working, honest people like President Yeh, who works tirelessly to make the world a better...
Hello.
You know what makes the Sandrock Commerce Guild great? Hard
so long, partner.
People like President Yeh.
Good day, partner. Ready to get your ride on? Yeehaw! Let's go talk to my pa at the ranch. He can lend you a horse for the day. I'll be right behind you. Bye! Hey, pa! I brought the new builder. I want to teach him to ride. Bring out the finest stallion we got. On the house.
Well, now, my little buttermuffin sweetie pie, I'd love to help out you and your friend here, but you know we don't lend out no horses for free.
Aw.
Don't you paw me, little missy. Now, you for a fact know that... Well, I guess it couldn't hurt just this one time.
You can rent a horse from my pa anytime you like. But what you really ought to do is head over to Construction Junction and get yourself a stable added to your homestead so you can keep a horse of your own. That'll make you a real yak hand. Just a horse owner, if you don't prefer that nomenclature. I had a lot of fun with you today. I'll see you around. Keep on riding!
So long, partner.
Hey there. So long, partner.
Hello. See ya.
Howdy. So long, partner.
Thank you.
Thank you.
fix that window, eh? Oh, splendid! Another fine contribution to Sandrock on behalf of the Commerce Guild. I'm sure they'll have a few kind words to throw my way at the next fireside, eh?
Hey there! Catch you later. Hey there! Don't forget to stop into Construction Junction sometime. Catch you later.
Howdy. Be seeing ya. Thank you.
Hey there, Builder. No doubt you've heard about the little bandit altercation. Let me just put your fears to rest. You've got absolutely nothing to worry about. The Silver Corps is on the case. Howdy. Be seeing you.
See ya. Take care.
Hey!
Howdy! So long, partner.
We're going to have lots of chances to work together, so let's get along. The improvement of Sandrock is our common goal, so let's do what we can to get results.
The breach here in town used to be one of the tallest buildings in the old world metropolis. It's still much shorter than the elevator in Tall Sky. See ya!
Hey there. You should use the combat square whenever possible. It'll give you valuable fighting experience. See you.
Hello. Farewell.
Hey there. So long, partner. Thank you.
comment. So long.
Excuse me, ma'am. Might I have a word? I'm new to Sandrock, and I would be remiss to pass up an opportunity to speak with a dignified-looking damsel such as yourself.
My stars! Did you listen to that? I reckon that must be the phrasings of a bona fide Taran gentleman. Nobody talks fancy like that around here.
Well, what can I do you for, newcomer?
Looking for good eats? Or just a place to kick up your heels? I've been ranching these parts for more than 20 years. Reckon I ought to know a thing or two by now. Just ask our builder here.
I believe you. I'm Ernest, by the way. I'm here on the behalf of the Atara Times. I was hoping to do a piece on that bandit fellow who's been giving you all so much trouble. Would you care to weigh in on the situation?
Oh, I reckon you mean Logan. Mr. Ernie, sir, I don't suppose you were on that train, were you? You still want to catch up with that rascal? Well, here's my weighing in. You'd do best by packing your bags. That Logan's a wanted man, and he likely won't take kindly to a fancy-talking, pants-wearing, city-slicking Point Dexter snooping around. No offense. If you want to write about something, write about the scenery. Try some of our Yakmol sausage. It's so good. People all the way from Portia make their way over to stock up on it. Logan, forget about it. Wait till the Corps catches him, then ask him yourself.
And it was going so well. I've really hit a wall these past few days. Can't seem to get anyone to open up. Are they really so afraid of one guy? Is it my cologne? You, Builder, despite all that, I don't suppose you would be willing to answer some of my questions about Logan. Yes, I've tried that. The minister, her second-in-command, the editor of your local paper, all of them have been most unhelpful. But rather than directly tell me no, they all just euphemistically tout off a no comment. Really? You will? Fantastic! One moment, let me just get out my notebook. For this interview, please try to be as objective as possible. Try not to let your feelings or any biases get in the way. It's important that I only get the facts as I try to understand this bandit persona. First question, do you know Logan personally? That's all right. Still, you've lived here for a while, haven't you? I believe your insight may yet be of use. Tell me what he looks like. I mean, have you seen the posters around here? They really couldn't have found a picture of him without a bandana over his face. Just a simple description will do. All right. Thanks. I needed that one. But I mean, the two of you? There's no sense in comparing you. You're just two totally different styles. When I saw him, I could tell even through the bandana there are stories just waiting to be told. Logan's accomplice, the man who helped him on the train. What do you know about him? What's his name? Haru and Logan. I see. Yes, I noticed that they seemed to be close. Each one seemed to know what the other was about to do from just a quick glance. So, that's all you know? Well, I appreciate your honesty. As a non-native Sandrocker, I suppose I should have expected as much. But I can tell you did your best. Thank you. In any case, I suppose this counts as my first complete interview. They sent me here to just do a little throwaway piece for Ernie's World. But this whole bandit thing is gold! My editor Eduardo is gonna flip. Bandits? On your train? It's more likely than you think. No, that's no good. Ne'er-do-well nabs nada? Oh, how cheesy is that? Hey there, kiddo. I seem to keep seeing you around. You're not following me, are you? Are you all right?
I'm fine.
Are you lost? Where's your mother?
I'm not lost. I live here. My ma's in the desert now.
Ah, I see. In the desert. Oh, goodness. Sweetie, where do you live? Do you need someone to help you get home?
No, you're Ernest, the writer. Did you write the Maltese Pigeon?
Oh, you're a fan, huh? Gosh, why didn't you say so? Oh, that book you've got, that's my latest release. Why don't I sign it for you?
Oh, that would be great! Thank you, Mr. Ernest!
Hey, anything for a fan. Who should I make this out to?
Jasmine. That's J-A-S.
And Jasmine, sweetie, why don't you tell me, what was your favorite part about this book?
Actually, I thought the story this time was a bit contrived.
Eh? Contrived? Wow, such a big girl word. Where did you...
I'm not finished. The characters are paper thin. And if you've even been paying half attention, you can see every twist coming from a league away. I think you've been really writing it in lately. Your old stuff was way better.
Well, little kid, with all due respect, you're a little kid and you don't know anything.
I'm your primary demographic!
Actually, as you can clearly see displayed on the back cover, the book is intended for all ages. Well, that's all the time I have for today. Here you go, and cheerio!
Wow, look, Mr. Teddy! We got an autograph from Ernest, the famous writer! Let's put it under our pillow tonight.
You really can't please everyone. She's kind of right, though. My novels have only ever really caught on with the under 12 demographic. It's gotten so hard to continue to outdo myself. Yes! The Maltese Pigeon is my most famous work. It's a classical whodunit mystery where it turns out it was the butler all along. Oops, guess I spoiled it for you. Well, it's still good. I recommend you check it out. Anyway, that little girl sounded a lot like my critics in Walnut Grove. They rated my latest novel a rotten score of 3 walnuts out of 10. But, I don't write for them. I write from the heart, okay? It was nice running into you again, Builder. But I really should get back to work. Despite the one-off critic here and there, plenty of fans are in fact looking forward to what I come up with in Sandrock. So long!
there. Bye.
Pass me more. Retreat!
Did you see that? Those darn Geeglers are at it again. Look at this mess. They're muddling up our water. I honestly don't know what it is they have against us. Do you mind helping out with the trash around the oasis? The longer they're in the water, the higher the risk of contamination, so we must hurry. I saw you helping out. Thanks. We all appreciate it. If you found any valuables in the trash, you can keep those. Isn't that great?
Catch you later.
Hey there. See ya!
Hi. Catch you later. Goodbye.
Hello?
Hey there! Catch you later!
Hello! We'll catch you later!
See ya.
Good day. How are you? I just remembered that we haven't introduced you to desert farming yet. We have a nice gentleman by the name of Zeke working on a moisture farm north of town. If you want some pointers on farming, you should go talk with him. I've already given him a heads up that you'd be coming. The farm's a bit far, though, so you might fancy taking a Yakima cart. Well, I'm on my way to see how Coop's doing, so you have a good day. So long now.
Hello. See ya.
That was a close one. Everybody all right in here?
Hello. You must be the new builder. I'm Zeke.
Now ain't the time for pleasantries. You big palooka. Look around. The whole moisture farm is trashed. I can't believe those darn Lissamen could be so audacious. This is a clear escalation.
The good thing about plants, Justice, is that they grow back. We'll be fine.
Is that thing over there important, Zeke? It looks pretty busted up.
Oh yes, the hydrogel. All the crops will die without that.
What? You're joking, right? I can never tell if you're serious or not.
No. I'm afraid there's nothing funny about it. Without a replacement, we could be in dire straits.
But this is something our new builder could help with, right? Right? That's the spirit, builder.
This main part of the moisture machine, it's kinda rare. And it looks like we'll need a new one. Chi might know something. You should speak with him, you know. Sooner or later.
All right, buckaroos. Look like we got ourselves a plan. Zeke, hold down the fort. You, head over to Cheese and figure out how to fix that hydro thing. Unsure, you're with me. Let's secure the perimeter.
Yeah, I think our best bet would be to ask Chi. He may know a thing or two about the hydro gel. For the rest of the damage here, I'll probably just ask the other builder for help. Also, you can recycle the old hydro gel. Go ahead and whack it a few times with your pick hammer. Put it out of its misery. Good luck, builder. Seriously, everyone is going to be counting on you.
Thank you.
Take care.
Yes? Are you here for the hydrogel? I've heard. I've a few ideas about how to make one. But quick, bring me 5 data discs, and I'm confident we can overcome this feeble challenge. Good. These will do. I'll send a diagram directly to your mailbox when I'm done researching. Oh, and one more thing. I'm quite certain that one of the materials you need for this, a condenser, can be acquired at the Breach, a ruins in town that has been closed off by the Civil Corps for some time. Speak with Justice about letting you in. That will be all. Goodbye, Bill. We meet again. See you later.
Thank you.
Hello.
Howdy.
Welcome all. For some of the new folks among us, I shall be reviving the age-old tradition of regaling y'all with the origins of our fine celebration. The Day of Memories is a festival celebrated all across the free cities. Some folk have different ways of celebrating, but the fundamentals remain. We all are aiming not to forget about those who came before us, paving the way. But the Day of Memories is not just about sorrow, not only about loss. Though it did begin as the result of a rather tragic event. Indeed, we aim not to mourn the absence of those since passed, but rather to honor their memory and look forward to the future. Like most things, we Sandrockers like to do things a little differently around here. Back when Martel had just discovered the Oasis, it wasn't that long removed from the Age of Darkness, when people were still cowering underground. Martel thought to organize a game not unlike hide and seek to finally take advantage of the freedom offered by the vastness of the above. She had people hang lanterns all across the forest around the oasis to tell our ancestors, as well as people traveling the desert, that we're here and we're doing well. We'll continue that tradition today. Let our tears and joy resonate across the desert. Let our departed ones know, with one voice, our one message. And that's that we're still here. Come, let us bow our heads and take a moment of silence in remembrance of those not with us to celebrate today. Now, without further ado, let the Day of Memories festivities begin!
Thank you.